The channel Unknown Physicist. So today we are in another video of our series Mastering MMP. So in our previous video of this series, we have completed linear algebra, complex analysis, Fourier series, Fourier transform, and Laplace transform. So the links of those videos are given in the description box, or else it will be going in the iCards. You can click there also and check, or else check in the playlist which is named as Mastering MMP. I'm sure those videos will really help to boost your preparation. And what we are going to see today is really very, very important. And one of the easiest paths where you can score your marks easily. And it is all about vector analysis. And today we are going to see some of the basic concepts, some of the basics which you need to solve. And this vector analysis is really very, very important in point of electrodynamics paper. There, the vector analysis will play a major part. And if you're a new visitor to this channel, in this channel, I do make videos on different concepts of physics. Right now, I'm doing two series. One is for mathematical and the other is for quantum. You can check those videos also. So let's get started with the video. Okay, let's get started. So you can see two images on the screen. So these two images are nothing but this particular image represents the, it is a pictorial representation of addition of vectors, whereas this is nothing but the pictorial representation of subtraction of vectors. So these are certain basics which you have read in your 11th and 12th grades. So you will see something more apart from that. So vector is nothing but something, a quantity which is having both magnitude and direction. Magnitude and direction. Right? So, can I multiply a vector with a scalar? Sure, you can do it. So, I'm going to show you some examples. For example, lambda and mu are some constant. If it is going to get multiplied with a vector, then you can write this as nothing. Lambda into mu a vector. Or else, this will be equal to mu into lambda a vector. So, you can multiply a vector with scalar. Similarly, lambda into a vector plus b vector. This is nothing but lambda into a vector plus lambda into b vector. One more thing. Suppose if my scalars are in addition form. So lambda plus mu into a vector. Then this is nothing but lambda into a vector plus lambda into, sorry, mu into a vector. So you can write your vectors in these form. And one more thing. Suppose if you are having three vectors, let it be e1 vector, e2 vector and e3 vector. So if it is lying in a three-dimensional space, then how you are going to represent it with the help of scalars? Then it is given by some vector a vector is equal to a1 e1 vector plus a2 e2 vector plus a3 e3 vector. Okay. So here e1, e2 and E3. These are nothing but your bases. We call this as your bases. So in case of three dimension, I'm having three bases, okay? And what about A1, A2, A3? A1, A2, A3. So A1, A2, A3 are nothing but your scalars. So these scalars can be a positive value, negative value, or else also sometimes zero. And we call this as components of a vector. We call this as components of a vector. With respect to the basis, these are our basis. So these are nothing but the components of a vector with respect to the basis. You must be clear with certain basic terms, because in sometimes in your exams they used to mention these terms. So you should be very clear with the basic terms, right? Next is. So now let me consider a Cartesian system. I hope most of you must be very clear with what is Cartesian coordinate. How do we represent? It represents the form of x, y, and z. So here I am introducing the unit vector. I am introducing the unit vector. These are very, very basic. We have learned unit vectors I cap, j cap, and k cap. So I cap corresponds to the positive x direction, j cap corresponds to the positive y, and k to the positive z. So here I have to represent the vector. For example, this is. I have a plane something, let this be I cap, this be j cap, and this be j cap. So I have to represent the vector. Then how would I represent it to a vector? It's like ax I cap plus ay j cap plus az j cap. Isn't it? So this is how we represent the vector. Coordinate. point I want to convey here is, so a vector in a three-dimensional space requires three components to describe fully both its direction as well as its magnitude, right? So hope this is one point which I want to convey here. Next is, let's see about addition and subtraction of vectors. So for example, I have two vectors. Let this be A vector, let this be B vector. So A vector is given by this way, and B vector is given by bx I cap plus by j cap plus bz k cap. Okay, so first what I want to do is, like, I want to do the addition of vectors. So I have to add A vector plus B vector. Okay, so then how it will be? So you will be adding both of these, right? So if I'm adding, I can take these components common. So it will be ax plus bx into I cap plus ay plus by into j cap plus az plus bz into k cap, right? So this is how we do addition of vectors. Similarly, if you want to subtract, that is, you have to find the difference by subtracting them, then it is a vector minus b vector. So this would be ax minus bx into I cap plus ay minus by into j cap plus az minus bz into k cap, right? So these are really very, very basic things. And one more thing you have learned, let me show the next slide. One more very frequently used term in vectors is nothing but magnitude. Magnitude. So let me consider the same vector. A vector is equal to ax I cap plus ay j cap plus az k cap. Okay. So the magnitude of a vector A is given by, it is denoted by mod A or just A. Okay. So in terms of components for a three-dimensional Cartesian system, the magnitude for this is magnitude is given by mod A is equal to nothing but the square of components. So it is ax square plus ay square plus az square. So this is how you find the magnitude. Next, we have something called unit vector. Unit vector. So unit vector is denoted as a cap. So something over cap. So unit vector is given by a cap. So how do we find a cap? A cap is nothing but a vector by mod a. A cap is nothing but a vector by mod a. So what is this unit vector? So this is nothing but a vector whose magnitude equals unity is called unit vector. Let me write it. A vector whose magnitude equals unity is called unit vector. Hope you got it. So these are certain basics. Next, let us see about scalar product, that is dot product. So what we are going to see here is about scalar product. So we used to call this as dot product also. Dot product. Okay. So the scalar product of two vectors A and B. So for two vectors A and B, it is usually denoted as A dot B. And it is given by A dot B is equal to magnitude of A into magnitude of B into cos theta. Magnitude of A into magnitude of B into cos theta. Okay. So what is this theta? So this theta is nothing but the angle between two vectors. So suppose if you are A vector and B vector, A vector and B vector are in this direction, and this theta is nothing but your angle. Okay. Similarly, the value of scalar product A dot B equals to the magnitude of A multiplied by the projection of B. So here your A is not equal to 0. Similarly, your B is not equal to 0. Then A dot B, what it is? It will be 0, right? So what I would like to say here is your A is perpendicular to B. Your A is perpendicular to B. And one more thing which you have to note here is, for the Cartesian basis, the vectors J cap and K cap also being mutually orthogonal unit vectors. So they should satisfy some conditions, which is given by I dot I is equal to J dot J is equal to K dot A is equal to 1. And the other case, suppose if it is I dot J, or else J dot K, or else K dot I, it is equal to 0. So you have to remember this criteria. This is very, very, really important. So this is for scalar product. And one more thing, always remember, scalar product has only magnitude. That is your dot product. Scalar product has only magnitude. It has no direction. It has no direction. And the scalar product has a commutative and distributive property over addition, which is given by a dot b is nothing but equal to b dot a. Similarly, a dot into b plus c. I mean, a vector, these are vectors, okay? A vector dot b vector plus c vector is nothing but a vector dot b vector plus a vector dot c vector. Okay, so let us do one sum from which you will get a clear vision. So here the first question is, find the angle between. So you have to find what is your angle between a vector is equal to I cap plus 2j cap plus 3k cap. And b vector is given by 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap. Okay, so we have to find what is your angle. So actually, a dot b is given by magnitude of a into magnitude of b into cos theta, right? So from this, cos theta is nothing but a dot b divided by magnitude of a into magnitude of b, right? So simple. So a dot b, what it is, you have to just do the dot product. So a dot b is given by 1 into 2. So here the coefficient is 1, your component is 1. So 1 into 2 and I dot I, it is 1 plus and then 2 into 3. So 2 into 3 and j dot j would be 1 plus 3 into 4. K dot k would be 1. Finally, we have 2 plus 6 plus 12. So, which is nothing but 20. And then, next we have to find magnitude of A. Magnitude of A is given by under root 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square. So, this will be almost under root 14. Similarly, magnitude of B, it is given by under root 2 square plus 3 square plus 4 square. Again, this is under root 29. So, now let me write here. Cos theta is equal to 20 divided by under root 14 under root 29. Okay. So just do the mathematical calculations and try to find the answers. And your answers should be in form of radians. Okay. Just give a try. Your answer should be in the form of radian. If you've got the answer, don't forget to mention in the comment section. You'll be getting in a decimal point. I don't need cos theta value. I need theta value in terms of radians, okay? In terms of radians. Just give a try, guys. Okay. Next is, one more important thing, it is a note. So, what if you are taking a scalar product of a vector with itself? So, what I'm meaning here is, you have a vector, a vector. You are taking a scalar product with the same vector. So, this is a dot a. So, which is given by nothing, mod a square. Because your theta, what will your theta? It will be 0 and cos 0 is 1, right? So your a dot a would be magnitude of a square. So that means it is nothing but under root a dot a. Under root a dot a. It is, this is what one note I want to convey here. Next, let us see something else. So the next one is vector product. Vector product. So we used to call this as cross product also. Vector product or else cross product. So vector product of two vectors A and B is denoted by A vector cross B vector. So this is how we represent a cross product. And it is defined to be a vector of magnitude mod A into mod B into sine theta. For scalar we had cos theta, here it is sine theta. So, for example, if you are having two vectors, A vector and B vector. So, this is your A vector, this is your B vector. Angle between them is theta. Then your A cross B is in this direction. Okay. So, what is again theta here? It is nothing but the angle between two vectors. Again, in scalar, we saw the properties, right? So, here, vector is distributive over addition. So that is A plus B cross C is nothing but A cross C plus B cross C. And it is anti-commutative and non-associative. So what it is? So B cross A, it is given by minus of A cross B. Minus of A cross B. So it is anti-commutative and non-associative. So A cross B cross C, it is not equal to A cross B cross C. Okay. So these are some of the properties which you should remember. And similarly, the properties of unit vectors and the cross product. So how in scalar we had I dot I is equal to 1. So here I cross I, J cross J, and K cross K. K cross K. These are equal to 0. Here it is equal to 0. So then it will be. So here. And one more thing. Vector products are not scalars. This is going to give you the direction. So if you have I cap cross J cap. Or minus J cap cross I cap. It is equal to K. So I can write this as. If it is J cap cross I cap. It is nothing but minus K. If you look here clearly. These are in cyclic. So I, J, K. Right. Your unit vectors are these. So it is in cyclic. So I cross J is K. And next is J cross K. This is J cap cross K. J cap cross K cap. It is nothing but I cap. So these are cyclic. And similarly, K cap cross J cap is nothing but minus I cap. And the last one is K cap cross I cap is J cap. If it is I cap cross K cap, then it is minus J cap. So using these relations, you will be getting your answers. You should be very familiar with this. And one more thing. So if I am having two vectors, A vector is equal to AX I cap plus BX J, A vector is equal to AX I cap plus AY J cap plus AZ K cap. And similarly, one more vector, B vector is equal to BX I cap plus BY J cap plus BZ K cap. Then how do you write A vector cross B vector? So it is given in the form of I cap, J cap, K cap. So you have AX, AY, B, sorry, AZ. Similarly, BX, BY, BZ. Okay. So this is also, your cross product can also be written in this form. So let us do one problem. So here the question is, A vector is equal to I cap plus 2J cap plus 3K cap. And similarly, B cap is equal to 4I cap plus 5J cap plus 6K cap. So here you have to find your vector product. You have to find your vector product, which is A cap cross B cap. So then this is nothing but you have to write in this form. So I cap, J cap, K cap. So for the A, it is 1, 2, 3. And for B, it is 4, 5, 6. So this would be I cap into 12 minus 15 minus J cap. It is normal determinant how we do in our matrices. So minus J cap into 6 minus 12 and then plus K cap into 5 minus 8. So finally this would be minus 3 I cap plus 6 J cap minus 3 K cap. So this would be your A cross B. So if they are given some angle, then you have to use the form mod of A mod of B into sine theta. Okay, you can use this way. So here I am going to just give the formulas and some tasks you can try by yourself. So next is scalar triple product. Scalar triple product. So we are going to have three vectors. So in that case, that is A, B, C. Then the scalar triple product is given by A dot into B cross C. A vector dot product B vector into C vector. Okay. So let me give the sim directly. So here your question is, A vector is equal to I cap plus 2j cap plus 3k cap. Similarly, B vector is equal to 4i cap plus 5j cap plus 6k cap. And your C vector is nothing but 7i cap plus 8j cap plus 10k cap. Okay, I've left the number 9. So these are your 3 vectors. You have to find the scalar triple product. So this would be your second question. So this is your second question. Next is vector triple product. Vector triple product. So vector triple product for 3 vectors. If you remember, in vector product we discussed that your vector triple product is not associative. So that is, A vector cross B vector cross C vector is not equal to A vector cross B vector cross C vector. Okay, so here we will be using two formulae. What it is A vector cross B vector cross C vector. It is given by A dot C into B minus A dot B into C. Similarly, the other side, that is A vector cross B vector into C vector. This is given by A dot C into B minus B dot C into A. I'm sorry, I've left the vector sign. So this is how given. So from this, finally, what you can write for a vector triple product is A vector cross B vector cross C vector plus B vector into C vector cross A vector plus C vector into A vector cross B vector. If you note, these are given in cyclic order. You should not change this. It should be taken in cyclic order. So here I am going to give you few tasks. Just give a try for all those. So the first task is, here I am going to give you certain statement. I just want you guys to identify whether those statements are true or false. So there are three general vectors A, B, C. Okay. So the first statement is C dot A cross B is equal to B cross A into C. I just want you to identify all these. And the second is A cross B cross C is equal to A cross B into C. And the third one is A cross B cross C is equal to A dot C into B minus A dot B into C. And the fourth one is D is defined as lambda A plus mu B. So here this implies A cross B into D, into D is equal to 0. And the fifth one is A cross C is equal to B cross C. This implies that C dot A minus C dot B is equal to C into mod of A minus B. Sixth one is A cross B into C cross B is equal to B into B dot C cross A. I have not put the vector sign, but I have given 6 statements. From these 6 statements, I want you guys to identify which are the true statements, which are true, which are false. You can just mention those number in the comment section. Okay, so this is like why I have given such a task is because in point of your GATE exams, such type of questions are asked frequently. So you have to make a practice over it. So just give a try for these. So in our next video, we will be discussing all about the coordinate systems and the main elements which we should know in each coordinate system. For example, if you have a Cartesian system, what are the metric elements, length element, volume element, area element. We will be discussing all those things for the 4 coordinate systems. So be ready, guys. So you will be getting the real feel of vector analysis from the next video. So whatever we discussed in this videos, all the basic things which you should know. So till then, everyone, if you have any doubts, Don't forget to ask in the comment section or else in the Telegram group, which is Unknown Physicist, right? And if you feel this video is going to help for anyone's preparation, don't forget to share this video. And if you want to appreciate the content went in this video, don't forget to hit the thumbs up sign. So till then, everyone, keep practicing. Bye-bye. Have a nice day.